Hi, and welcome to Embase Search Basics. This video will cover how to do a quick search in Embase and how to use some of the available search filters. You can access Embase from the homepage of the library website. For this tutorial, we will be doing an example search on physical therapy for traumatic brain injury. To start out, I will type my first concept into the search bar. You will notice when you start typing that a drop-down menu will appear. This contains suggested standardized terminology for your topic. If you see your term or concept in the list, go ahead and click on it. This will be the most effective way to start for a basic search. Now I will type "and," then my second concept of physical therapy. The drop-down menu is indicating that I should choose the term physiotherapy in this case. Having the word "and" between your concepts is important because it is telling the database that you want articles containing both of these concepts in your results. Now click on the blue search button, which is already previewing the number of results you have with these search terms. We have about 960 results. Before we start using any filters or adjusting our search, let's take a look at the details of how our search was interpreted by Embase. Look at the top of the page just underneath the search bar to see your search history. You can see that Embase actually searched each term twice, once with /exp next to it and once by itself. The terms with /exp next to them are subject headings, or standardized labels that the database uses to group together articles on the same topic, even if they use different terminology to describe it. The /exp terms were searched within the labels on each article record, while the terms by themselves were searched in the title, abstract, and other parts of the article records. This strategy ensures you are less likely to miss articles on your topic. Let's now take a look at our results. At the top right, you have options for how your results are sorted. Sometimes Embase defaults to sorting the results by publication year. If you prefer to see the articles that most closely match your search terms at the top, you can change the sort order to relevance. On the left side of the screen are a series of filters we can use to narrow down our results. I'd like to find the most recent literature, so I'm going to limit the publication date. When you expand the publication years filter, you can see how many articles in your results are from each year. I'll click on the first three to limit my results to articles published in 2018 or later. Once you select the years, click the blue Apply button at the top of the list of filters. Just using the date filter removed over 2/3 of the results. If I want to narrow it even further, I could consider additional limits such as age group or study type. If you would like to view the abstract of any article, click on the abstract button underneath the citation. Next to that button is the index terms button, which shows you the subject heading labels that have been applied to each article. Next to that is the yellow Find It button, which will connect us to the full article through the library's subscriptions. All the way to the right, there is a button to pull up similar articles. Those are the basics of doing a quick search in Embase. I hope this tutorial has made you more confident in using this database effectively.